BV-238. The stakes involved in World War II were astronomical. It was a struggle for survival till the very end, and that is why scientists and engineers worked tirelessly to give their countries technological superiority. It was a time of astonishing ingenuity in military technology, with both the Allies and the Axis powers seeking to outdo each other in the laboratories as well as on the battlefield. This fierce competition gave rise to many amazing developments in military technology. One such development was the Blohm & Voss BV-238. It was a German flying boat that was the heaviest aircraft ever built when it first flew in 1944 and was the largest aircraft produced by any of the Axis power during World War II. Today's video will discuss in details the development and notable features of the amazing aircraft. Before we begin, we would like to ask you to subscribe to War Secrets and press the bell icon to get instant notifications about our latest videos. Now, let's begin. Development. With the success of the previous Blohm & Voss BV-222 flying boat, Dr. Richard Vogt, the chief designer of Blohm & Voss, began working on an even larger improved design in the form of Blohm & Voss BV-238. As the BV-238 development began in the last stages of the war, only one aircraft was ever completed and used only briefly. In 1937, Lufthansa opened a tender for a long-range passenger flying boat transport that would be able to reach New York in 20 hours. Blohm & Voss eventually would go on to win this tender. The chosen aircraft was a Blohm & Voss BV-222 designed by Dr. Engineering Richard Vogt. In 1941, Dr. Richard Vogt began working on a new aircraft larger even than the already huge Blohm & Voss BV-222. In July the same year, he presented to the RLM, the German Ministry of Aviation, the plans for the new Blohm & Voss BV-238. This aircraft was, in essence, a modified and enlarged version of the BV-222 powered by six Daimler-Benz DB603 engines. Three aircraft powered with this engine were to be built, belonging to the A-Series. Six more aircraft were to be powered by six BMW 801 engines, and these would be designated as B-Series. To speed up the development and avoid wasting resources if the project proved to be unsuccessful, the RLM officials asked for a smaller-scale flying model to be built first instead of a working prototype. This scale model plane was named FG-227 and was to be built and tested in Prague. The construction of this scale model was undertaken by a group of Czech students under the direction of well-known glider pilot Ludwig Karch. It was to be powered by six ILO Fi-2400 engines pushing 21 horsepower each. As it was meant to be tested on the ground and not in the water, the FG-227 was provided with landing gear which consisted of two wheels in the nose and two more wheels placed on each side of the wing. When the FG-227 was completed, it was to be flight tested. From the start, there were issues with it, as it was unable to take off under its own power. After the unsuccessful start, it was disassembled and transported to the Travemünde for future testing. During transport, French prisoners of war deliberately damaged one of the wings. Once the damage was repaired, it was flight tested. But during the flight made in September 1944, all six engines stopped working, which caused an accident where the FG-227 was damaged. After yet another major repair, a few more flights were carried out. The FG-227's overall performance was disappointing, and it didn't play a major role in the BV-238 development. Construction of the first BV-238 parts began in early 1942. The final assembly was not possible until January 1944. Due to a shortage of materials and the increasing assaults in the Allied air forces, the BV-238 V1 first prototype could not be completed until March of 1945. The first flight test was conducted immediately after its completion. However, sources do not agree on the exact year when this happened. Proposed role. Throughout the BV-238 development pace, it was often discussed precisely which role it could fulfill. While it was primarily designed as a transport plane, a new idea was proposed to act as a U-boat support aircraft. This would include carrying supplies, fuel, torpedoes, and men to the U-boats operating in the Atlantic. Of course, by the time the first prototype was near completion, the war was almost over. This proposal was realistically not possible. Plans to use it as long-range bomber carrying 6,2400-kilogram bombs also never materialized, as the Allied bombing raids effectively destroyed the Blumenvoss factory in Hamburg. Orders came down to hide the BV-238 from the Allied Air Force. The question was how to hide such a huge aircraft. The Germans did try to do so, but the aircraft was eventually found by the Allies, who managed to sink it. The circumstances are not clear to this day, as both Americans and the British pilots claimed the kill. It was destroyed by a group of American P-51 Mustangs belonging to the 131st Fighter Group. The kill was made by a leading P-51 piloted by Lieutenant Urban Drew. There are some rumors that the BV-238 was actually developed as an escape aircraft for high-ranking Nazi officials. It was rumored that Martin Bormann had plans to use it to escape Germany in early 1945. Of course, due to Allied Air Force supremacy and the BV-238's large size, this may have not been a viable plan if ever attempted. If it was put into production, the BV-238 would have had the honor of being the largest flying boat that saw service during the war. While it only performed test flights and was never used operationally, it was nevertheless an astonishing engineering achievement. Design. The BV-238 was designed as a six-engine, high-wing, flying transport float plane. The BV-238 fuselage was divided into two decks. On the upper deck, the crew and the inboard equipment were housed. The lower floor was designed as a storage area during transport flights. In theory, there was enough room for around 150 soldiers in the BV-238. A huge front hatch door was provided for easy access to the fuselage interior. The wings were constructed using large tubular main spars. The wings were used to provide additional room for spare fuels and oil tanks. The wings were provided with flaps running along the trailing edge. The large size of the wing construction allowed passageway for crew to be installed to have easy access to the engines. Unlike the BV-222, which had a pair of outboard stabilizing floats mounted on each side, the BV-238 had only two. The BV-238 was powered by six Daimler DB603 engines. For self-defense, the BV-238 was to be provided with two HD-151 twin-gun turrets with 20mm 0.78-inches MG-151 cannons, two HL-131V turrets with four 13mm MG-131 machine guns, and two additional MG-131s mounted in each fuselage sides. Despite the plans to arm the V-1 prototype, this was never done. The crew number is mentioned as 11 or 12, depending on the source. The sources do not specify the role they performed. It can be assumed, based on what is known from BV-222, that there were at least two pilots, two mechanics, a radio operator, and a machine gun operator. The BV-222 had a wingspan of 196 feet, and it measured 145 feet and 36 feet in length and height, respectively. It had a wing area of 3,875 square feet and was powered by six 2,900 horsepower Daimler-Benz DB603 engines. It had an empty weight of 120,500 pounds, maximum takeoff weight of 207,990 pounds. Its maximum speed was 220 miles per hour, while the cruising speed was 210 miles per hour. It had a range of 3,790 miles and a maximum service ceiling of 20,670 feet. Production. The production of the BV-238 was carried out by Blumenvoss factory in Hamburg. Only one completed prototype would be built during the war. There were also at least 2 to 6 more prototypes under construction, depending on the sources, but due to the war ending, none were completed. The small number under construction may be explained by the fact that, in the late stages of the war, the Luftwaffe was more in need of fighter planes than transport planes. In addition, there is a possibility that the BV-238 project was actually cancelled by the RLM officials. This brings our video to an end. We hope you liked it. You can support War Secrets by liking this video and subscribing to our channel. We will see you in our next video. Till then, take care. Bye.